Hi there, guys, and welcome to today's emergency episode. We're going to talk about Improbable and Unity, and the result of their dispute is PR nightmare that get a lot of games offline recently. First of all, let's learn something about Improbable. This is a company that has a product, Spartal OS. Most of the game makers use their product for online mass multiplayer real-time gaming. They have ability to create real-time shooters that can be cross-platform like iOS and Android, and they're considered to be one of the best solutions in the market up to date. Their recent competitor Google is struggling to have the competitive product at this moment. What's more important is that this company was founded in 2012. They received nearly $600 million in investment, and they have around 200 employees in their company. So they are way past the early startup stages of the company. They have a product in the market for some time, and they have a lot of happy customers using their product. They even made an investment in UK-based game studio called Automation. So I'm expecting that they're going to be staying in this industry for a longer time. Now, on the Unity side in this dispute, that because Improbable is a cloud computing company, their product is helping game developers use the game engines, whether it is Unity, Unreal, or some other engine, to make their game cross-platform and work in real-time multiplaying online, something that players like very much. Now, on December 5th, in 2018, the change in the Unity terms of services and partnership agreements was about how are they going to cooperate with other third-party providers. And they made a change that they are not going to allow any more new entry for the cloud computing and somebody who could offer a cloud solution. And that's fine. That means that there are no other new people coming, or that the existing partners need to have additional discussions and communications. But what they did on the 9th of January in 2019 is they shut down everybody using Improbable's software. And this led to many games gone offline. So all of this is because Unity want to add a new business in their portfolio, and that's cloud computing with Google, partnering with Google. Beside all the things that have been said and the blogs and the PRs, I just want to say you can see clearly that Unreal is going to take a full advantage of this PR nightmare, and they're going to make a partnership with Improbable, because they're a competitor to Unity, and they're making $25 million fund to help everybody transition to away from Unity, because Unity and Unreal are two rivals offering similar products. And this is a very tricky time. We did a video recently about Unreal and what they're going to do with the Epic Store and everything. So I'm just want to bring you guys, open your eyes more closely and choose wisely what services you're going to use and what products you're going to use when you're building your next games, because there is clearly going to be two different fractions in the game industry, and we can clearly see that Unity and Unreal are taking their sides right now. Take care, guys, and see you in the next episode. Stay up to date by following this channel, and don't forget to leave the comments and ask anything you want to know about any topic in the game industry. Take care.